So Brandon Crown, it's a busy day today, Sunday. A lot of people here at your gym. What's going on?
We do the female sparring on Sundays. Open to anybody in the area who wants to come with some cardio for the minimum of 3 rounds and a coach to watch them. And, of course, some positive mental attitude. And then other than that, just working everybody. Sundays are typically pretty busy days.
What was the talk in the gym today after all the fights last night? The two upsets in the UFC, the upset in boxing with Jesse Vargas?
Yeah, people are really talking, of course, about Conor McGregor, the Jesse Vargas fight, and King Kong Ortiz, and all the Showtime fights as well. It was a good night for fight fans last night.
Zach, do you know Conor McGregor? Have you met him?
No, I've never met him. But I wasn't mad that he lost last night.
Why? Because he called out Floyd?
It's just like, look, people lose and it's okay. But when he was like, I am the belt, or like, it's just a little much for me. I don't have that attitude. I'm also not undefeated. Neither was he, though. And I get like, you gotta be confident, but you just don't gotta be an asshole.
But I do give him credit that after the fight, he kept his cool. He didn't walk out of the octagon like other fighters. He congratulated his opponent. It humbilized him. He became more
humble. Even like, look at Broner walking out of the Madonna fight. Like, you just look like you look even shittier after the fact. I think.
I like Broner.
Or like, look, like, you know, get.
There's got to be one guy out there.
I like Broner too, but be humble before the fight. Just be cool. Don't be a dick. Like, just general law. Like, just don't be a dick.
Yeah, but maybe they tell them to be like that to market. Because
to build a fight.
It's all PR, man. It's all shtick.
Because they're watching the first face-off this week between Conor McGregor and Nate Diaz was identical to the Holly Holm Ronda face-off, where they told the opponent, come in and stick your hand out, put it in their face, and they told the other person to slap their hand. It looked kind of like orchestrated.
I mean, this fight was made for those press conferences. This fight was made for those Instagram clips.
But what about McGregor jumping up? You fight at what, 40, 47?
47.
Imagine you're fighting up to 178, to light heavyweight, in one night. It doesn't make sense to me.
You gotta be pretty,
It's ballsy. It's overconfident, clearly. It's just overconfident. That's exactly what we want.
One person calls overconfident, maybe another one calls arrogant.
Or someone told me that he was costing the UFC too much money, so the UFC wanted him to, like, lose to, like, keep him humble. I don't know.
I don't think that was planned out.
Look, Dana White was probably having a heart attack last night, man. Trust me, he wanted Conor McGregor to win.
Of course. And he wanted Holly Holm to win.
But look at, like, Holly Holm took a loss last night, but she wasn't a dick. And she didn't have a bad word to say before. And she takes a loss, and it's kind of like, oh, I hope you do well. Like, I would watch you again, and vice versa, because you don't have, like, that bad taste in your mouth of the shit-talking and this and that.
The fans love that. Nate Diaz, this is after the fight, he goes, there's a new motherfucker in the building. You know, stuff like that. Like, that's how, he doesn't care.
Yeah, but it's also just this different era. Like, fans used to love, like, classiness. It's this Floyd Mayweather era where everyone needs to be undefeated, and now prospects won't fight other prospects because they're afraid to lose their O, and we don't get these great fights. Because there's this new era, but back in the day, if you took a loss, you'd rematch, you know, 3 weeks to a month later.
That's true.
No big deal, as long as you showed up to fight. Like, that's what made fans.
Okay, last question. Is Holly Holm Buster Douglas, who came in and beat Tyson?
No.
She came in and she beat Ronda Rousey?
I think she's a 5-time boxing champion.
Yeah, she's proven competitor.
I think six.
You know what Holly Holm is going to do? She's going to go back to the gym and get better at that shit. You know what she's done every time? She's tasted a little defeat, and she's proven to you she's all fighter. You know, she's going to be back, and she's not going to end up in a diabetic coma or anything like that.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned right here. FaceReport.com. Melissa Quack reporting. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.